Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to create a custom dialog and display multiple dialogs on the same page. Look at this example, where you can see a subscription dialog with a confirmation dialog. In the dialog, I enter an email address and click the subscribe button. The confirmation dialog is displayed with the buttons yes and no. When the yes button is clicked, the subscribe and confirmation dialogs close. If I click the no button, the text box value resets, and the confirmation dialog alone closes. Let's see how to achieve this customization at the code level. First, I open an existing Angular Dialog application, where I have already configured the component with the height and width properties. I have also set the show close icon property to true to close the dialog when the close icon is clicked. And I also imported dialog module from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular popups package. If you want to know how to add a dialog component to an Angular application, I have linked the getting started video in the above YouTube card and the description below. Now, I will run this application using the command ng-serve. You can see the dialog component with custom height and width. Now, I am going to design a custom subscription dialog. First, I add 3 ng template tags with the reference variable, header, content, and footer template. Then, I set the header content to subscribe to newsletter within this division element. I add content to the dialog by defining the division element with the appropriate content inside the span element. In the footer, I want to add a text box to collect email addresses, and a button component for readers to subscribe to the newsletter. To add a button, I install the button package using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2angularbuttons --save. As I have already installed the Syncfusion Angular Buttons package in my app, I am skipping this step here. Next, I import the button module from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Buttons package. I also register it within the imports array of the ng module section. Now, I make changes to the app component HTML file by adding the Angular button component with the button text subscribe. I want to set the button type as information, so let me define CSS class property and assign this class eInfo to it. Next, to add a text box for the dialog to get the email address, I define an input element of type text within this division element. Then, I add a placeholder property for the text box component to display a short description about the input field. Also, I define a few CSS styles for this header content and close icon, dialog content, and footer text box and button within this style.css file. If you look at the output page now, you can see the subscribe to newsletter dialog. Next, I will show you how to add multiple dialogs. I want to display a confirmation dialog after the subscribe button is clicked. So, I add one more Angular dialog component with the height, width, and show close icon properties containing appropriate values. Then, I define the ng template tag with template reference variable inside the division elements. I set the header to confirm subscription and the content to are you sure you want to subscribe to the newsletter? Since I want to display the confirmation dialog after the subscribe button is clicked, I add a click event with the appropriate handler in the subscribe button component. Initially, the visibility of the confirmation dialog should be false, so I define the Boolean variable confirm dialog visibility is false within this app component TS file. And assign this variable to the visible property of the confirmation dialog. Next, I define the event handler subscribe button click and set the confirm dialog visibility to true. Here, I am going to add two buttons for the confirmation dialog. I define a variable of type button props model. This button props model interface is imported automatically from the Syncfusion Angular popups package. Then, I will add button model property and set the button content to yes and no. I plan to set the primary button style for the yes button, so let me add the is primary option as true. Now, I need to assign this variable to the button's property of the confirmation dialog. In the dialog, I enter an email address and click the subscribe button. The confirmation dialog is displayed with the buttons yes and no. Now, I will show you how to close the subscribe and confirmation dialogs when the yes button is clicked. And close the confirmation dialog when I click the no button. To do that, I need to add click event for yes and no buttons with appropriate handlers. As I said before, to close confirmation and subscription when clicking yes, I need both the dialog objects. So, I add a reference variable for these dialogs and access it using the view child directive within this app component TS file. Then, I define two variables, subscribe dialog object and confirm dialog object of type dialog component, to get the dialog instances. Also, the view child directive and dialog component class get imported from Angular Core and Syncfusion Angular Popups package to access the child component instances. Next, I define the event handler, confirm dialog yes button click, and close the subscribe and confirmation dialogs using the public method hide. Then, I define this event handler, confirm dialog no button click, and make a call to the public method hide using confirm dialog object to close the confirmation dialog. When the no button is clicked, I want to reset the text box value. So, to access the text box input element, add a reference to the text box component code and define its instance of type element ref. And this class is automatically imported from the Angular Core package. Then, I set the text box value to empty if the text box is not empty within this event handler. In the dialog, I enter an email address and click the subscribe button. The confirmation dialog is displayed with the buttons yes and no. When the yes button is clicked, the subscribe and confirmation dialogs close. If I click the no button, the text box value resets and the confirmation dialog alone closes. In this video, we have seen how to customize the Create Custom Dialog and display multiple dialogs on the same page. If you would like to see this working example, you can download it from the GitHub link shared in the description below. You can also grab a free license key to use our complete Angular suite if you fit our community guidelines. So check the link in the description to see if you are eligible for our community license. If you found this video useful, please click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thank you for watching.